Well, hidey-ho there again, boys and girls. Welcome to yet another edition of Live from the Tape Farm. Today we're going to be doing a little review of a guitar. So this is the Firefly, the FFHB, also called a Crossroads. And it is a hollow body, 2P90, true hollow body, very hollow. Stock all the way down here. It is a good looking guitar, no doubt. You can see the arch. Hopefully you catch that in the light and my fingerprints all over it because I've been playing. Oh yeah, wait a second. I left this on just for you guys. Okay. Yeah, a few things in life more satisfying than that. So as you can see, it's got a tune-o-matic bridge, trapeze, tailstop, and overall, very nicely put together guitar. And dirt cheap. I think it was $170-ish. It really is, right out of the box, it was a very good playing guitar. The action was pretty high. Needlessly high. I lowered it, and I'm probably going to lower it some more. But the neck is in really good shape, and these block inlays are done so much better than the FF338, the blue guy right there. The block inlays are done so much better. You don't see any filler at all. None. It's just done really, really well. Frets polished fairly well. Still getting some Firefly finger. And there are some now. It's been very cold here in Nashville over the past few days when, you know, we don't have RVs blowing up downtown. And this right here, I do feel some sprouting here. Now, when it came out of the box, didn't feel anything at all. But over the past few days, it's been very cold, kind of dry. And I am feeling some fret sprouting. Not a huge deal, very easy to fix. You may or may not run into that with yours. Tuners, pretty standard tuners, but they've been great. No issues whatsoever as far as tuning stability. It's been really good. It says it's a bone nut, and I don't have anything. I can't say that it isn't a bone nut. The cut is fairly good. There's a couple of them that are a little wider than they need to be, but overall, I haven't had any issues with the nut. A couple of areas that, could be better, okay? The bridge pickup is way far away from the strings, so I bought a little spacer to put in there, and we'll be putting that in a little while. This switch is a little squirrely, so we're gonna take the strings off, we're gonna pop this guy out, we're gonna pop both pickups out, take this switch out and see what's going on with it. It's just kind of in the middle, it's iffy. So you don't always get both pickups in the middle. So we're gonna see what we can do with that. I bought some new knobs because I think these black speed knobs look silly on here. I mean, it doesn't look bad, but come on. You know, it's supposed to be like a vintage kind of jazz box kind of feel to it. The thing that I am always impressed with Firefly on the hollow bodies and the semi-hollow bodies is when you look at it straight on, you do not see any wires. Go look at some Harley Bentons. Go look at other guitars in this same price range that are hollow bodies, and even in the pictures you're going to see wires coming through here, and you don't see that here. They tie them up really well and you don't see any wires. Now that's great as long as you're not going to do anything, but since I'm going to be doing some stuff that might, you know, I gotta find the wires and untape them and everything, but it's a very nice touch. Binding on the neck is really, really nice. The binding on here is pretty sweet. It's got kind of a off-white, kind of almost vintage kind of look to it. You know, overall, the guitar build-wise is fantastic. Sound-wise, it's really good too. Neck pickup, really good. What you would expect from a guitar like this. It's got that very round bottom end feel to it. That's what you would expect, kind of a jazzy, low mid feel. The bridge pickup is there, but it's not that it sounds bad. It's just so far away from the strings. The volume level between the two is drastically different. So when I first got it, I was playing it on the neck pickup. I switched it to the bridge, and I just thought the bridge pickup was broken. I thought it was like, oh, well, the bridge pickup doesn't work. And then I realized, oh, no, it's there. It's just because acoustically, when I was playing, you know, I heard the guitar acoustically over the bridge pickup coming out of the amp. So it was that drastically different in volume. I think that's an easy fix. The bridge is okay. Again, it's that standard Firefly bridge, and you might want to consider replacing it. I've already started to hear some buzz out of it, so I think it may need to go, but we'll see. We'll see. If I do replace it, I'm thinking of replacing it with something a little bit more befitting the guitar. Some sort of wood bridge, a rosewood bridge or something like that. But I'll play with it and see what I come up with. But what we are going to do with this guy is we're going to put a spacer in here. We're going to check out this switch. I have another switch that if I need to replace it, I can. We're going to check that out and see what's going on with that. We're going to replace the knobs. That's what we're going to do. But first, I wanted to do a little tune with this as it came out of the box. So, and this is a red letter day here at Live from the Tape Farm, because I'm actually going to play lead guitar on something. Don't get your hopes up. Don't get your hopes up. But what I did is I just wrote this little jazzy kind of thing. I am not a jazz player. I am not a jazz musician. I know there are people who are, and they astound me with their ability. I am not that guy. So I did just a little thing based on what I can do, and we'll check it out. So what I did is I did the, for the rhythm track, I did the neck pickup on the left-hand side. I did the bridge pickup on the right-hand side. So if you really want to, you can balance back and forth to hear the two pickups. Now, what I did have to do is I did have to, you know, raise the gain on that on the neck pickup. I'm sorry, on the bridge pickup to get them even. So don't say, oh, what is he talking about? They sound exactly, you know, exactly the same volume. Yes, now they do. But before I did work on the gain structure, not so much. And the lead was played with both pickups. So that is, it's mostly neck, because mostly neck is coming through. Has kind of a Christmassy, jazzy sort of thing going on. But let's check it out. All right, let's get the easy stuff out of the way. We'll do the knobs. So, one man's opinion, but I think they look better. So that's one thing out of the way. Let's get strings off, get these pickups out of here, and see what we see. See if we can't put a spacer in there, get this switch out, and see what's going on with it. Now, one thing that I'm a little unsure of, I have a hollow body Aria up there, the green one, and the bridge originally was not glued in at all. It was just a floating bridge. So anytime you change the strings, positioning the bridge, you know, became a little bit of an issue. So what I hope to do here, just put like a piece of painter's tape along the back edge of the bridge, and just to mark where it is. So when it comes time to put the bridge back on, if it does come off after I take the strings off, I'll know exactly where it's supposed to be. And then we can go from there. Now, what I did with the Aria, and, you know, if this is the case on this, I'll do the same thing, was just drill a little hole on either side, and then with a dowel, glue a dowel in there, and then it sits in the hole on either side and makes it a lot easier to put the bridge on and off. But we'll see. We'll see what this one is. As soon as I can get this tape through here, there we go. Get this tape through. Put it right on the edge of where the bridge sits. There we go. Okay. So now we can take the strings off, and if the bridge moves, we know where to put it back. So the bridge does come off. It's got some rubber gasket down here as well. So that's interesting. So it comes off. Probably should have marked where on either side here as well, but that's pretty easily figured out. So the bridge comes off. So if I want to put on a different bridge, that would be fairly easy to do. Let's get looking at everything else. I'm going to change the strings as well. But let's get the pickups out. Guard off. What do you guys think? With or without pick guard? Oh, no, I'm torn on that one. Got some schmutz here. It's underneath the underneath there. Probably some leftover polishing compound or something. So it's a full size P90 hole in there. Not a lot of wire for me to move things around with, but that's okay. We'll see what we can do. All right, we'll get this other one out, and then we'll see if we can't figure out what size. I have a couple of different sizes as far as rings here to raise this up. See if I got the right one. That would be helpful. All right, so here are our pickup rings. There are three different sizes. I'm pretty sure the middle one is what I'm going to need from what I remember. So, but to put this on, I actually have to take all of it out. Luckily, it should be fairly simple coming out through the pickup holes. So, just so I can get to this wire. Now, another way to do this would be to just cut this right here, put this on, solder it back together, and put some shrink wrap on it, but I don't want to do it that way. So we're going to try to do it the right way and go from there. But before we do all that, let's see if we can't figure out what might be going on with this three-way switch. See if we can't get that out through this pickup hole. All right, so there's the switch in all its glory. Let's see if we can't see what might be the cause of the intermittent behavior we are seeing. See if we have any cold solder joints. No, they all look good. It's actually a really good job soldering. Let's check the switch itself.
So what it looks like,
let me get one of these switches here just so I can bring it up to the camera and show you. If you've never seen one of these things, the way it works is this little toggle goes back and forth. And what it does is it pushes this contact away from the center contact. So your center contacts is what all these hot wires go into. When you move this back and forth, it's just disconnecting one from the center. And then when it's in the middle position, then both are making contact. So what it looks like is this switch here, one of the center contacts is bent in a little bit too far. And to be totally honest, these two switches are nearly identical. So they're probably the same exact switch. So rather than desolder all that, I'm just going to bend that little piece out a little bit, and that should solve that problem. Probably shouldn't have put on the knobs first. Classic Keith maneuver. All right, so there's all our guts. All out of the guitar. The pickups are fairly well wax potted, which was nice to see, and that probably lends to why they're not as microphonic as some of the other Firefly P90s that I've run into. So what we need to do is, this here is the bridge pickup, so that's the blue wire. We just need to find where it goes and unsolder it. So it goes over here. So we'll get it off of there, feed it back through, put the pickup ring on it, and get everything back together. Okay, so I just clipped it off of the potentiometer for now. And then I'm just gonna try to pull it through so hopefully don't have to undo all this tape. Now I did something with the FF338. I put new pickups in that and completely gutted it, and you can watch that video up yonder somewhere and see the process of getting all that out of there. Okay, so like I said, I'm pretty sure it's this one, but really want to make sure. So let me fudge this in here just a little bit and put a couple of strings on it, or just put some strings over the bridge to get kind of an idea where this is, and just make sure that I'm right, because nothing would be, it'd be really bad to say, yeah, it's this one, only to have to find out that it's not that one, and then have to do all this again. All right, yeah, good thing I checked, because it actually ended up being the smaller one. So that's good. Let's see here. Yep, definitely the small one. All right, now we can start putting her back together. All righty, so what you can do is, as you take things out, you can attach a piece of string to each component and do it that way. But there's, with the pickup holes and everything that are in here, it's really, I thought it would be just as easy to do it this way. So put a piece of string, attach to the potentiometer that goes there, pull it through. So I'll do that for each one, and then we'll pull them through and we'll be able to reattach them. All right, I'm gonna attempt to pull these through. I don't really need to put anything in here because I think I can just reach in and get those in there. So let's get these pulled through and hopefully this will all work. All right, and then the jack is through. All right, now we just gotta get everything back together. All right, so we got all the electronics back together. I'm gonna do a little oil on the neck. All
All right, there's your Firefly finger right there. So yeah, there's a quite a bit of residue or whatever that crap is that gets on your fingers. Still have it on here from earlier. But yeah, clean it up real nice. Looking pretty good.
Well, boys and girls, that should about do it for the Firefly FFHB Crossroad. The raising that pickup definitely did help. I've played a little bit, and I may put the other pickup ring that I was thinking, the larger one, just to see if I can't get that bridge pickup just a little bit louder. But it's much better than it was, for sure. And I don't know about you, but I like those kind of vintage, kind of aged looking knobs on there better than the black ones. Now, earlier when I took the pick guard off and I said, oh, what do you think? Pick guard, no pick guard. Well, up underneath here is some orange peel kind of paint. So little paint imperfection up underneath the pick guard. So it will be a pick guard on the guitar for sure. I'm thinking about getting like a tortoise shell, like maybe a blank tortoise shell piece of pickguard material, and seeing if I can cut my own pickguard on here. I think a torty pickguard would look a little sharper on here than this pearled white pickguard. I would say installing the pickup ring is the only thing that absolutely needs to happen on this guitar. Everything else is, I mean, chances are you're not going to get a switch that's squirrely. Your switch will be fine. Oh, yeah, by the way, in the interim of while making this video, I had hand surgery again. For those of you who know a little bit of my history, I've had surgery on this hand for various reasons, and I had to have surgery on this hand. I have an issue with my fingers locking up. Anyway, surgery on this hand, so what are you going to do? So really, I think the only thing you have to do is raise this pickup. Other than that, you know, everything else is personal preference. I like these knobs better and they're cheap. I'd like a torty pickguard on there because I think it'll look better, but you don't have to if you don't want to. Great, great guitar for the money. It's got a nice chunky neck and it doesn't sound bad acoustically either. See if you can find one. They're kind of hard to find, I will tell you that. I got lucky. Check it out if you can. Questions, comments, concerns, rise of outrage, hit me up in the comments below, and please be kind about my lead playing. Because I know I'm not a lead guitarist. I get it. Anyway, we'll catch you guys later. See ya.